students, welcome you all for the new chapter of physics, that is chapter number 3, machines. They have reduced bit in this machine chapter, that is, you already know that is levers, the concept of lever, type of levers, class 1, class 2, class 3 has been removed from your syllabus. So we have from first part of the machine, that is machines and technical terms, and in the part B we have completely pulley, we need to study about all the pulleys. So this machine chapter you have studied in your grade 6. If you remember still, in the physics grade 6, they have given you the introduction about this machines chapter. So what exactly is a machine? See, machine is a device which is doing our work easier. Means in spite of you, that the machine is going to do that. Now almost all of the things is being done by machine system. We take like a vacuum cleaner is a machine. Right, what it is been happening there, it removes all the dust from the house or anything, car, in car also we can use a vacuum cleaner. Like this machine has been doing our work easier in day to day life. So first let me give you the introduction regarding the machine chapter, then you will understand it better. So about a machine, for example, think that first one, to open a nut. To open a nut, can we do it by hand? Can we open it by using a hand? No, we are not able to loosen it or tighten it by using just the fingers of hand. So in that, what do we use? See, I will show you that. So you people know this very well, right? What it is? It is a spanner, which is being called. So for example, for loosening the nut, you can use like this. For tightening the nut also can be done by using this. There are different types of spanners according to the size of the nut. Means what it is making me? It is making my work easier and by applying a less effort. Right? So by using the spanner, I can apply a less effort.
So think there is a big stone. A
big rock or something else, small one you can consider. In this case, can you shift it by your hand? Can you shift it by your hand?
No.
We are not able to shift it by your hand because when we are shifting it, we need nearly 10 to 15 members to move it at once. But for example, if 2-3 members are doing that work, we will use some type of machine called what we mean by crowbar. Have you seen the crowbar? Then if you place this side, then we'll be doing it. So in this case, we are using crowbar as our machine which is doing our work with a less effort. See, effort is the one which we are doing on the machines. Understand? Load, though there is a term called what we mean by load. Load is supplied by the things which we are applying effort. For example, in this case it is rod. Here it is bucket. Bucket is in turn having some load which we are overcoming by using fully the effort what we are. So understand. So what is the use of machines? Machines are doing our work with very easily. Means we are applying less effort. That's all. That is the only thing we are getting from that of machines. Understand? So machines are a very important part in our life, day-to-day life. So first now, let us see which are the four important functions of machines. What are the four important functions? Then we will define what you mean by machine, what is, because to define a machine in an effective scientific way, we need to understand the four functions of the machine, which is very, very important. Then we will go for the technical terms, I think which you are already aware of, but if being aware also, you will go with the technical terms to make you to understand the concept very clear. There the technical terms for load, effort, mechanical advantage, velocity ratio, all those will come. As of now, we will go discuss about what we mean by four functions of the machines along with the example. Then we can define the factor of what you mean by machine. Now, let us see what are the functions and the uses of the simple machines. When I just explain this, you will remember what are the things you are doing in your home with the help of the machines, whatever we are having. The same thing we are speaking now, but in the technical terms of science. It is not something which is different other than from our daily life. See, what is physics? Physics is a branch we study what is there in the nature, what it is being already exists of. So, this is how we have to be doing that. Let us see the functions one by one and what are the uses of the simple machines. First of all, in lifting a heavy load by applying a less effort, machines, one type of machines can be used as, see, these all are the functions of machines only. But each machine differs with what is its function. Because the same machine cannot do all the type of functions, right? We use the same machine for all the purpose. No, we use different machines for a different purpose. For example, lifting a heavy load, we use one machine called crowbar. For example, for taking a bucket of water from the well, we use a machine called what we mean by pulley. For opening a nut, we use a called what you mean by wrench or a spanner. See, different. Right? This is what the functions also differs. So in lifting a heavy load by applying a less effort. See, why we are using our machines? We have to do the same work, but we have to use a less effort. Our work should be less. It's not like we use the machines for doing our work, we get more strength. No. We have to get less strength, but the amount of work that we do. That is what the concept of using the machines instead of redoing it, right? So in lifting a heavy load by applying a less effort, that is, it acts as a force multiplier. Whatever the force be, we are applying a less force, but we are lifting a heavy big stone from one place to another place. Means whatever the force we are doing, the machine is converting it into double. It is acting as a force multiplier. So which are the machines that makes us to use the force multiplier? Let us give an example. See, a jack is used to lift a car. First you do one thing. You try to lift a car with your own hands. No, it was not possible. Now you take the help of a machine called jack. By using a jack, you can lift a car. Means, this time also you are applying the same force which you tried without jack. But how could you be able to lift the car? Means, whatever the force you are doing, the jack is multiplying the effort. And we are easy to, that is, force is getting multiplied in this case. And easily we can lift a car by using a machine called what you mean by jack.
See, a crowbar is used to lift a heavy stone. Try to lift a heavy stone through your hand. Just not possible. But now, when you take a crowbar and start lifting, easily you can lift. Why? Here, whatever the force is being applied to you, it is getting multiplied. So this is one of the function of a machine. That is, we lifting a heavy load by applying a less effort. That is, as a force multiplier. Then we ask you an example. Give an example from force multiplier. You can give this. Understand? So it is very important. Let us go for the second one. In changing the point of application of effort to the convenient point. See, you all have a bicycle. In a bicycle, where do you apply effort? We apply effort on a pedal to move it, right? But think over it. When you are applying effort on a pedal, think that there was no chain. If there is, for example, you all have felt it, all this you have identified dysfunctions, right? When the chain has fallen down, when the chain slipped it, can you be able to move friend by using a bicycle even though you apply effort on the pedal? No. We need a link of a chain which is being attached to the back tire tooth rail, we call it as. So you are applying the effort friend in the case in the pedal, but you are able to move it by using the bicycle with the help of the chain. So here we are changing the direction of effort. Point of application of effort. Application of effort is not backwards here. In case it is pedal to a convenient point. This is what the bicycle. Look here. You are playing it on a pedal. Excuse me. See here, you are being attached to this chain. Chain is being attached. So by pedal, you are making this chain to rotate. So the bicycle is keep on moving. This is also one type of functions of a machine where we apply effort at different place, but we can make work that is good. The point of application of effort is changed. Here the point of application of effort is changed from the pedal to the rear wheel of the chain. We may be applying an effort on pedal, but it's like applying it on a rear wheel by using of what? By using chain. If there is no chain, we are not able to apply. See, instead of applying the effort here, I'm applying my effort on a pedal, which means it's like more or less applied on rear wheel to my bicycle. That is what it is. In changing the point of application of effort, here the point of application of effort is changed from pedal to rear, even though you are applying the effort on a pedal. Understand? This is also a function of what you mean by machine. Second one. Let us go for third one. This already I have given you the example. In changing the direction of effort to a convenient direction, we are changing the direction of effort itself. Look here. Observe carefully here the physics of work power energy is needed. Concept. See, for example, this is a well. In a well, there is a water. There is steps for the well. Consider. There is a step soup. To count down. Take a bucket of water and go. So when you are doing in this case, you are lifting a bucket in which direction? You are lifting it, okay. Bucket has this chain. So you are lifting it in upward direction. You lift the bucket like this and go. Means you are applying a force. Against the force of gravity. You are applying a force upwards. Means you are doing your work against the force of gravity. In case other than this, what can we use? We can use a pulley, a single fixed pulley like this. Understand? A single fixed pulley when you use, see, pulley will be like this. Okay. So you will be outside. Okay? Outside the well. So when you apply the bucket of water here you are applying in each direction. You are taking a pulley downwards. You are having pulley down means you change the direction of effort. Without pulley, direction of effort upwards. Understand? You need to spend a lot of effort. But if the direction changes, means you are moving the pulley towards the direction of work. Means you need not up. You are applying a force towards the force of gravity, not against the force of gravity. When you apply a force towards the force of gravity, you need to apply a less effort. they won't take the cement, stones, anything from down to up. If they are taking what, they are going to work against the force of gravity. In turn, they will use these pulleys, you might have seen, where they will tie a sand and they will, two members will be down, they will have that. There will be one member in the first floor who will be taking that from downwards by using a machine called pulley, where they are doing the work in a very faster way also, and they are doing the work with less effort also. So that is the use of third use. This is very, very important. Understand? Because the concept of pulleys, the concept of pulleys we are going to study in the part B section of the machine chapter, is very, very, very important. 100% questions are there from that. So now let us see the last one. What is the use? For obtaining gain in speed, that is greater movement of load by smaller effort. Greater movement of load by smaller effort. See, this also you might have seen. By obtaining gain in speed, how this is also called as, see, first is called as cost multiplier, this is called as speed multiplier. Speed multiplier. What is it? See, when a pair of scissors is used to cut a crop, its blades move longer than the crop by its hands moving into it. For example, take the scissors.
Overcomes a large resistive force. It overcomes a large resistive force and
some point when you're applying a small force. This is called as first use, first function, force multiplier. See, you are applying a large resistive force by applying what? Small effort. By applying a small effort, you are coming out a large resistive force. At a convenient point, point number two, by changing the point of application, that is convenient point, in a desired direction, that is which one? Function number three, desired direction, asked by which we can obtain gain in speed. Speed multiplier, that is function number four. By combining all the functions, we are defining a machine. That is simple. See, don't bypass nothing, bypass here. Understand. Machine is a device by which we can either overcome a large resistive force, that is load, by some point, by applying a small force. We are applying a small force that may be as force multiplier, or that may act as a convenient point, or changing direction, or speed multiplier. Understand? But machine is what? This is applying a small force. Only in all the cases we want to apply a small force. That is, our effort is less, but we are overcoming a large resistive force in a desired direction, or by making obtaining a gain. This is how we define what you mean by machines. When we ask define machine in the sense, we need to write this definition only. So I hope today's class was useful to you. That we have discussed about what you mean by introduction part of a machine. Then we have seen what are the functions and uses of a machine, and we have defined what is machine. So from the next class, we will define all the technical terms. Some technical terms and a concept of levers. Concept of levers was there in last year, but this year they have been removed due to this pandemic situation. So we will not discuss on the levers. So next class we will be discussing on the technical terms. To learn the technical terms, these functions, this is very important to know. So understand the concept clearly. So we will meet up in the next class and then.